First of all, let me explain what I mean by Tawhidic values. Of course, based on the term, it means that we are talking about values that are based on the principle of Tawhid, which means the unity of divine attributes and qualities, as signified by the beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yani Asma al-Husna. Al-Asma al-Husna. These beautiful names of God signify the various names and qualities. And values based on divine names and qualities, when realized by human beings, these are called human values. For example, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is merciful, caring. So human beings also possess that quality. Yeah? Some people have better qualities than others. Allah Ta'ala also has created human beings with a certain constitution. In Islamic intellectual tradition, it was stated that Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, the fourth caliph of Islam, used the word al-alam as-saghir. Literally, it means the small world. But this was also a philosophical concept, scientific concept, meaning microcosm. It means that everything that exists in the world external to us also exists in the human being. And everything that exists in the human being exists in the outside world. So, what's important to know is that the human constitution has spirit, ruh, soul, nafs, aql, intellect, reason. All these are major components of the human being. So when you talk about values, we talk about, in the case of human beings, we are referring to values associated with these different parts of the human being. So why do we have spiritual values? Because we have ruh, spirit. Why do we have intellectual and rational values? Because we have intellect, aql. Why do we have these moral, ethical values? Because we have nafs. So it is about how things associated with this. But here we are talking about environmental ethics. So I'm saying that when we talk about environmental ethics, we may classify values into four categories: the spiritual values, the intellectual, rational values, also scientific values, the artistic and technological values, and then the moral, ethical, legal values. There are four major classifications of the so-called religious values. And all these values are relevant to environmental ethics. Some values are more relevant than others. And for example, the ecological values of balance, unicity, harmony, equilibrium. Because we know that the natural world, before being destroyed by human being, is characterized by these things. So science tells us that there are limits to living forms, to natural forms, to natural laws and natural relations. Example, the food chain, the life chain. The idea is, based on the principle Tawhid, it means that all parts of nature are interrelated and interdependent. What is today called ecology precisely refers to that. What is ecology? Ecology is about relationship between all different parts of nature. If you affect or damage or destroy one part of nature, that the rest of the nature is going to be affected. Say, for example, in Malaysia, there are plenty of forests, jungles, trees. If you destroy the trees over a short period of time, then they will have effect on the climate, for example. There may be flooding, soil erosion, and so on. So that kind of the interaction, you know, this ozone, yeah? Because we use refrigerators. Refrigerators. You can imagine how many refrigerators there are in the whole on the whole planet Earth. But there's something that is emitted by these refrigerators, that carbon monoxide, that, for example, if it's too much emitted to the air, it's going to cause to damage ozone. Once you damage the ozone layer, then the amount of sunlight coming to Earth will also be affected. You consider distance between Earth and the sun. It's very far. And yet, because we damage, we destroy one part, then the rest of nature is going to be affected. That's meant by ecology. Isn't that the spirit of Tawhid? Yeah, that is Tawhid. Tawhid. Although God has many names and qualities, and yet God is one. Not many. So that is the same thing with the artistic and technological values. Nowadays, while we have this rapid problem of environmental destruction, because we are introducing technology. In pre-modern times, it doesn't matter how many trees you cut, it's not going to cause any upset to the ecological balance. But today, because of technology, you can destroy nature in a very, very fast way. So, in the question of built environment, there's another environment. Apart from natural environment, we have the built environment. We build houses, we build buildings and roads and so on. These are human construction. Don't you think that these things also can have an impact on our environment? How we build our homes, how we build our high-rise apartments, all that's going to have effect on the quality of the environment. And this is where, in Islamic tradition also, we have these guidelines for architecture, for city planning. I'm talking here about before, not now. The cities of Cordova, of in Spain, of Baghdad in Iraq, and Damascus in Syria, they have their own city planning, but those city planning were based upon the principles of Islamic environmentalism.